Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can implement pre-increment and post-increment operations using operator overloading in C++. Before starting, you can note my information. You can connect with me by following these details which are available in front of you. Now coming on to the topic, you can see a code which is implemented in front of you. The comment is showing the objective post increment and pre increment operations using unary operator overloading in C++. For this purpose, I have included a header file iostream. Then std namespace is used. Name of class is number. Inside number class, n attribute is declared. Then public section is defining first function, that is read. Inside read function, cout is printing enter a number message on console. The entered number will be stored inside n variable, and that n is going to read through scene statement. After that, print function is implemented. Inside print function, value of n will be displayed on console. After print function, there are two functions are defined. You can see first function is defined with name ++, and second function is also defined with name ++. Both have same name. Now I am removing this int for demonstration. So now you can see both the functions are sharing same name and they don't have any arguments. So in C++, if two functions have same name, then the concept of function overloading applied. But function overloading says you have to pass different number of arguments or different type of arguments. But here in both the functions, no argument is passed right now. So let's see whether it will work or not. You can see it is showing an error message. So you have to remove this error message by passing an argument in any function. But here you have to remember that you can pass argument in post increment implementation only because it is pre-decided. So whenever you are implementing post increment operation, you can write any data type inside parentheses. And in case of pre increment operation, you can leave these parentheses blank. Now, if we go through with the definition of post increment operation. So first temporary object is declared, then value of n is assigned into t.n, and then n is incremented. So you can see first value of n is assigned and then it is increased. So it is post increment operation, and at last return t is returning t object which is containing a particular value. And you can also notice that return type of this function is number, which is written here. Now coming on to the second function, which is implementing pre increment operation. Here again number class object t is declared. Now you can compare both the definition. Here n is incremented first and then it is assigned into t.n, and then t is returned to the main function. So now you can compare both the definition. First one is implementing post increment operation and second one is implementing pre increment operation. Now main function definition, here four objects are declared, n1, n2, n3 and n4. n1 and n2 are calling read function, then n1++ it is calling pre-increment definition, and plus n2 will call, sorry, n1++ is calling post-increment definition, and plus n2 is calling pre-increment definition, and then print function is called for n1, n2, n3 and n4 objects. Now I am executing this code. I have entered two numbers, 1 and 2, and you can see the output. It is displaying 2313. So n1 is printing 2 and n3 is printing 1. Now you can see that first n1 value will be assigned into n3 because it is post increment operation. So n1 is 1, so n3 will become 1, and after increment operation value of n2 will become 2. So n1 is printing 2 and n3 is printing 1. In case of pre increment operation, first value of n2 will be increased. So current value of n2 is 2, so it will be increased to 3 and then it will be assigned into n4, so it will also become 3. Now you can see the output, n2 and n4 both are printing 3 on console. So I hope you have understood how you can implement pre and post increment operations using unary operator overloading in C++. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Sanjay Gupta _Tech School. Thank you for watching this video.